A great storyteller once identified the ultimate answer to life, the universe, and knowledge as 42. When you reach 42 years in life, you have been adulting yourself for as long as you were a child, and you've been doing it independently. And half a lifetime ago, if you had told me I would ever be an honors college student, I would have laughed hysterically. When my math professor on trying to decide, you know, what career to do, my math professor said, check out engineering. And I thought, well, engineering kind of seems kind of boring, so I have a great interest in genetics. I have a daughter with a rare form of Down syndrome, or trisomy 21, and I was armed with a high school education when they delivered the diagnosis. And I had no clue what mosaic translocation trisomy 1 meant. And the doctors reassured me that it's okay, it's just Down syndrome. I had the guidance of the American Academy of Pediatricians because they had published guidelines for healthcare. So this kid came with instructions. I knew what to check, who checks it, when to get it checked. She came with therapists, specialists, everybody who knew how to take care of Down syndrome. And we did meet some people who didn't know how to deal with Down syndrome. It's the most common genetic mutation that is survivable in the human race. It's when you have an extra copy of the 21st chromosome, which is the 3, the trisomy. In her case, the mosaic means that there's 2 types of cells present. Normally, it's typical cells like you and I have. And the others are trisomy 21. Well, her cells got all mixed up, and she has parts of 4 chromosomes in one cell, which physicians have always told me is not compatible with life. Me and my high school education didn't know any better, so I did everything that I could just to keep her alive. And physicians really only talk to you if you know how to talk to them. So I had to learn about the different organ systems, how they cooperated, and how things could go wrong. So I knew what questions to ask and to get the support that I need. When a child is born with Down syndrome, you become a part of a large community of other parents who kind of have to play it by ear as well, even though the specialists are familiar with what goes wrong. So when I started my education, and that teacher said, try engineering, I knew that this is what I needed to go for, because I had a lot of unanswered questions, and I knew a lot of other parents that were in the same situation as me. So I'm here to learn as much as I can about molecular biology, so I can help other parents understand what goes on with their children when things go wrong. And that half a lifetime ago, when I was 21, I had no clue that my life was about to change by having a daughter with Down syndrome. I did know that whatever I put into her is what I would get out. So when the first physician explained to me that my child was a mongoloid retard, who would never walk without assistance. If she learned to talk, we would never understand the words she said because of the mouth formations. And that ultimately, the level of medical care that she required would far exceed my capacity as a young child at only 21. But I knew better, and so did my daughter, because she has defied every odd that they have put against her. She's 20 years old. She's a self-advocate for Down syndrome. She actually just went to Tallahassee this week. She is a multiple gold medalist for the Florida State Olympics in various sports. She is a USAG international medalist for rhythmic gymnastics. She was a four-time national championship cheerleader. And one of our hometown heroes throws this big prom every year in different areas of the world called A Night to Shine. And last year she was selected to be a spokesperson or representative for the Tim Tebow Foundation's Night to Shine program. So the real cute blonde in the blue dress, she's famous. And I'm just here learning more about her and more about me. As an adolescent suicide survivor, I never planned far in advance. And I never expected to be here. But I am here because I meant to be here, just as I know you all are. We have very unique paths, and a lot of times life throws things at you that you just cannot anticipate. And that's okay, because you have the strength and the will and the ability to get through it every day.